you're a cowboy today.
You don't act like the man from the stories I've heard.
The American television drama Yellowstone premiered in June 2018 on the Peacock Network. The series follows the conflicts happening along the shared borders of a large cattle ranch, land developers, and a native reservation. It's made waves since the first time it appeared on air. In June 2019, the series was renewed for a third season, and in February 2020, it was renewed for a fourth season with filming and casting continuing until July 2021. In this video, we're going to be talking about the show's most heartbreaking moments, from the first episode until the latest. Sit tight, because here we go. But before we get into the video, don't forget to leave a like and subscribe to the channel with notifications on so you don't miss any of the new videos we post. Season 2 ending with what many consider a white supremacist bloodbath. Everyone knew that the Beck brothers were bad, but the last episode of Season 2 highlighted the extent of their moral corruption, as well as their connection to white supremacists. Although the Dutton family is problematic in their own way, they've somewhat redeemed themselves because they helped kill some of the white supremacists who were wielding machine guns. The moment is heartbreaking because lives were lost, but in a sense, it's all for the good. The Dutton family, as well as the Broken Rock Indian Reservation, came out together for a full-out Quentin Tarantino-style shootout that took out numerous neo-Nazis connected to the Becks. These guys were bad, and all the racist propaganda made it clear that they were evil people. There's nothing more dangerous than gun-toting, brainwashed white supremacists. Another heartbreaking moment was the intense finale of Season 2 when Rip finally got acknowledged by the man he's looked up to since he was a teenager, John Dutton. It was a tear-jerking moment as Beth read her father's last letter to Rip. In the letter, John revealed that he was leaving Lee, Zelda's son, to Rip. How did Rip feel about it? Cole Hauser was more than happy to explain his character's rollercoaster emotions in Yellowstone's Behind the Story featurette. You know, I think he's just blown away, and I think there's that kind of emotion to what John has done for him and how much it means to Rip. But I think also, you know, the beginning stages of it, her reading that letter, he's kind of confused by calling Rip his son. I think he's so taken aback that he's like, did I hear that? Did that really happen? And so I think, you know, obviously he wants to hear it again and he realizes that he did call him. You know, that was his, you know, just tear-jerking and heartbreaking. Viewers will remember that earlier in the second season, John made a deal with Rip with a demotion of sorts to make room for a heightened role at the ranch for Casey. Rip dealt with it like a champ, and even though he was still recovering from getting shot, he continued doing his duties at Yellowstone. That is where Beth found Rip to tell him the good news. Finally, Rip's hard work and loyalty has paid off, and he's gotten the respect he deserved from John. One of the most moving things in the letter was John calling Rip his son. Beth and Rip getting engaged was another moment that was memorable. It wasn't heartbreaking, but it was a good thing for Beth to finally get her father's approval to marry Rip and took it upon herself to propose to him. This came not too long after she resigned herself to the idea that she won't get married to Rip. Fans supposed that her father, learning the truth about what Jamie did, led to Beth being able to take the step even though Rip was still in the dark about it. Rip told Beth that he couldn't go to the courthouse because all records of his existence have been erased. But Beth didn't let that get in the way, and they shared the emotional commitment in front of her family. Although fans were thrilled that Beth and Rip finally got to marry each other, there were two serious concerns, and one is that Beth is keeping the truth about Jamie and why she cannot have kids from Rip. Could lead to a breakup because Rip is in the dark about it. She may be afraid to tell Rip everything because it could mean losing him. In Season 3, Jamie also learned that he's adopted. The moment it was mentioned that he needed his birth certificates, Jamie learned that he was adopted. At first, he was in shock and he tried to deny it, but the evidence was just overwhelming that he had no choice but to accept it. Towards the end of the episode, he confronted John about it, and then his father revealed everything. His biological father beat his mother to death when he was just 3 months old. There's nothing more heartbreaking than that. His father went to prison for what he did, and the Duttons adopted Jamie. Although John insisted that he loves Jamie, he offered very little in the way of compassion for his son. Evidently, John was still upset with how Jamie treated Beth, and despite what he said, he never really loved Jamie. Beth confronted him about his treatment of Jamie in the last season. Viewers will remember that she said John will never love Jamie the way he loves her and Casey, and now we finally understand why. Deep in his heart of hearts, he doesn't love Jamie because he isn't his blood. Casey was not spared from heartbreaking moments too. In episode 7, he was investigating the theft of cattle from the Dutton family ranch, and it led to a bloody confrontation with the thieves. He was heartbroken when he saw the possible daughter of one of the men he killed, and she was crying over his body. He looked devastated and he blamed himself for the man's death. It was the second time he saw the daughter or son of someone who got caught in the crossfire. Although Casey is trained and he knows all about combat, he's not immune to heartbreak and ripple effects that someone's death can cause on others. Such confrontations can take a toll on his marriage to Monica, and everyone's wishing that Monica continues to support him in everything he does, as she has done so in the past. Casey has learned a valuable lesson the past season about accusing an innocent person. He's kept that lesson close to heart. As we all know, Yellowstone is coming back for a fourth season, and although we're still waiting for the release date, Paramount Network has said that revenge will be worth the wait. What does that mean? Although there's no release date, a teaser for the upcoming season has informed fans that they can expect new episodes in the fall. Joining the cast for season 4 are actors Piper Perabo and Jackie Weaver. The Dutton family may be dysfunctional in so many ways, but fans just can't seem to get enough of them. Luckily for fans, the Kevin Costner-led series is coming back for more, though details about the new season remain scarce until today. That being said, we've heard some interesting tidbits, so of course we want to share with you the latest scoop about the show. Are there any spoilers for season 4? Well, given the way that the third season ended, we know that the next season will be just as dramatic as the last. Even the actress who plays Monica, Kelsey Asbill, isn't sure how the show will move forward. In an interview with Good Housekeeping, he said that the end of season 3 is the most jaw-dropping, and I'm wondering how they'll move forward. It's funny because Taylor Sheridan has always told us that he knows how the show is going to end, and I'd love to know. Wes Bentley, who portrays Jamie, is excited to explore more of his character's past in the next season. He'd like to know where Jamie ends up, and he's also excited to see who Jamie really is, because he spent much of his whole life not really being himself. He thinks that it's going to be very interesting. Hopefully this means that the show will uncover more of Jamie's history. Cole Haas, who portrays Rip, has stayed mum about what's to come on the family ranch, but he mentioned a deadline that everybody's in danger in Montana after the bombshell that was season 3. The show will be following a new format in the coming season due to Paramount Network's rebranding. They plan to present the show as a cinematic experience, and there's a possibility of programming 2 episodes in a single night with limited commercial interruptions. If that means fewer commercials and more episodes, count us in. There's nothing we'd like better. Will the entire cast be back for season 4? Initially, there were some concerns that Luke Grimes and Kelly Riley are leaving the show, but it seems that the entire crew will be back for season 4. Costner, who not only plays the lead role and executive produces the show, remains its backbone. In the past, he's mentioned that he remains committed to the show. Unless the showrunners decide to write off any characters, it seems that the core cast will return for the fourth season. However, only time will tell if newcomers such as Jennifer Landon, John Emmett Tracy, Josh Holloway, and Kiorianka Kilcher will be able to survive all the chaos in the family and the ranch. The new additions are Piper Perabo, who will play a protester from Poland who is vehemently against the state-funded police force that protects the killing of animals and industrial farming. Ben Little will play Carter, a young reminiscent of a young Rip. Jackie Weaver will play Caroline Warner, the CEO of Market Equities, and Catherine Kelly will play a vet tech who strikes up a relationship with a Dutton Ranch cowboy. That's all we have for you today, folks. What are you most excited about for Yellowstone Season 4? Let us know in the comments section. Stay tuned for more exciting videos from our channel, and we'll see you around.